Could those on-stage stare-downs between presidential contenders be scrapped in the near future? This week, the schedule for three general election debates between the eventual nominees was set, though it's unclear if they'll actually happen.
Will the president participate in
it? I would refer to the campaign on that particular question.
While that's for the general election, President Biden already balked at the idea of primary debates, choosing to all-out ignore Marianne Williamson and RFK Jr., who, partially for that reason, switched from a Democrat to an independent. And the Republican Party is boycotting the general election showdowns sponsored by the Commission on Presidential Debates, claiming unfair treatment in the past. And Donald Trump has yet to debate his Republican primary competitors.
He owes it to you to be on this stage and explain why he should get another chance.
The debate over debates intensifying as Trump and supporters pressure the GOP to stop the primary ones altogether, calling them a waste of time.
He feels, as the former president, he shouldn't have to be on the debate stage, that he's going to earn the nomination a different way.
Presidential debates have taken place every election cycle since 1976, and in recent years, as many as two-thirds of Americans have said they've been helpful in making up their minds. And they've had critical impact dating back to 1960.
The candidates need no introduction.
When a more polished and camera-ready makeup-wearing John F. Kennedy squared off with a sweating Richard Nixon, who in turn lost that election. But as they rely instead on the bully pulpit, podcasts, or carefully curated TV appearances, those vying for your vote seem less interested in facing their opponents head-on and possibly leaving the podiums without an eventual president behind them. In Washington, I'm Scott Thuman.